That is the checklist complete.
Today, Heli-Med 01 is now back in service with pilot Adam at the helm.
He's up, up and away.
He's on the early shift with Paul and Jeremy when they're called to St Mawes, a remote coastal village.
We're going to a gentleman that's fallen off his bungalow roof. And he's 70 and he's query pelvic leg injuries, which are, when you're the older you get, the more problematic that can be.
The route takes them across the South Cornish coast, famous for its many peninsulas.
So just over 7 minutes to the overhead.
The village is on one of those peninsulas and would take over 45 minutes to reach by road.
Up with the nose, tail is clear, continuing down.
But Heli-Med 01 arrives at the scene in just over 10.
What's holding you? I can jump out if you like.
The door?
Yes, mate, clear door.
Hello there.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay.
How are you doing? You're Anthony?
Yeah.
Hi, Anthony. I'm Jeremy. This is Paul.
Hello.
So what's actually happened this morning?
I've been working on the roof and I fell off from that height down here.
And what's happened as a result of that?
Well, I fell on the hip.
Okay.
On the left hip.
77-year-old Anthony was alone in the garden when he fell from a ladder.
Have you got any pain in your neck at all?
No.
Fortunately, a neighbour heard his cries for help and they called 999.
Chest doesn't hurt at all?
No.
Not finding any difficult breathing?
No.
And your tummy feels okay?
Yeah.
Perfect.
We were trying to establish, was it actually, you know, a pelvic injury? Was it an upper leg injury or was it a hip injury?
Can you move this leg, the right leg okay?
Yeah.
But you just can't move the left leg?
No.
Okay.
Anthony, I'm just going to gently feel your leg.
Mm.
Is it painful at all?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It's possible that you've broken this bit of the leg, not the top bit of the leg, because it's quite swollen and it's a bit painful. So what we're going to need to do is straighten that for you, right, which might be a little bit uncomfortable, and then get you onto a stretcher.
If you were to break a femur, which can lead to significant blood loss, also bones are very sharp when they break. They can damage other structures such as nerves, you know, ligaments and tendons and muscles, and you know, which can lead to mobility problems.
Jeremy decides to give Anthony Penthrox, a fast-acting pain relief drug.
Just pop that in your mouth. Long, slow, deep breath for me.
In a minute, we're going to move your leg, and that's going to be very uncomfortable for you. So the more you breathe that in, the better it's going to be.
As they get to work, a Coast Guard team arrives from nearby Port Scathode to help.
Jeremy himself is a Coast Guard, so he has a great working relationship with the Coast Guard. So he asked for assistance, and they were, you know, they were brilliant.
So we're going to try and move your leg now. You keep breathing that gas.
Ready?
Yeah, mate, whenever you are. Keep going.
Keep going, Anthony.
Anthony. Slow breathing.
Slowly in.
Slow breathing.
Although I've got quite a lot of traction on it.
How's it feeling?
Oh.
In your mouth. In your mouth. You need to breathe the gas.
Oh, there, yeah.
Anthony.
Yeah.
Right, we're going to need to move it again in a minute. How painful was that for you?
Oh.
And do we need to give you some stronger medicine?
On the edge. Just about on the edge.
Good, that's okay
well
then.
Done. Well done.
Let's keep with that, go with that gas then.
Ultimately, we were suspecting that his femur was broken into two pieces.
That's much better.
Getting that under there.
And what we wanted to do was pull that leg in straight alignment and prevent further injury from the fragments of bone. So to do this, it's extremely painful for the patient.
Right, Anthony, to get you out of where you are, it's going to be quite difficult. It's going to be very painful for you.
No.
Paul and Jeremy need to give Anthony a stronger painkiller, ketamine.
We're going to give you some really strong medicine to try and take that pain away, and then we'll try and sort your leg out and then get you out of the vegetable patch. Is that okay?
Yes.
We use ketamine for a procedural sedation.
Anthony.
That's hurting me a lot.
Anthony.
What this does, it disassociates the patient from the pain that they're experiencing.
Oh, wife then?
Anthony.
Oh, don't pull so much. Yeah. Now my fame.
There's always a risk with ketamine. You never really know how any patient's going to react to it.
With this stuff that we're going to give you, it can make you feel a little bit funny, OK? So what we want you to do is we want it to be nice and quiet for you, and then when you do feel a little bit funny, everything's going to be fine, all right? So I'm going to start giving you some medicine, and I want you to tell me when you feel a little bit strange.
So with ketamine, everyone's slightly different, so you give the appropriate amount of drug, but you're never quite sure how they're going to react. So it's a very closely monitoring how they're doing.
What's your name?
You know, there's a fine line between giving enough for sedation and giving too much, and you're always balancing that against how they're reacting.
What's your name? We probably should start, Okay. Well done, Anthony. You're doing ever so well, you're fine. You're just in a really good spot. We're just trying to sort your leg out for you, okay? What's your name?
You happy to come around this side?
Okay, now's a great time, Paul.
Yep.
Nice and gentle.
What's really hurting is the bones grinding like this. So what we do is we sedate him and then we pull traction so the bones separate, so therefore it doesn't grind anymore.
That's it, perfect. Right, let's get that scoop in.
Sats are 100, hand title is 4.6. He's going to go this side towards you first, so we get that under.
You're doing really, really, really good.
Ready? On, brace,
roll. You're doing well, Anthony. Oh. Let's over
with
those,
Stevie. How are you feeling, Anthony?
I'm okay.
Good boy. You back with us now?
Yeah.
You back in the land of the garden, are you?
Are you?
With Anthony's legs straightened, Jeremy radios ahead to Trelisk Hospital in Truro.
Mid-shaft of femur, me and Paul will be taking this patient in a helicopter to Trelisk.
We made the decision to fly him to Trelisk. Ultimately, he had sustained a femur fracture, which required urgent hospital care.
OK, so we're going to lift you up on the stretcher now, and when we do that, because we're going to take you up to the air ambulance, we're going to fly you to Truro. If your pain gets very bad, can you let me know? Because I can give you some more medicine to stop that pain.
So it was about a six-minute flight from St Mawes to Trelisk. If he'd gone by road, it would have probably been 45 minutes.
Right, thanks, guys. Really appreciate your help.
The door closed in.
Yeah, please, mate. Just to protect your ears, yeah.
Turn the nose to right, I'll aim at the power line to highest point. We'll dive down to the left. If needed, looking for about 180 feet, went for the north.
Yep. So you are clear left.
All right.
So 3 minutes to the overhead at Trelisk, Jeremy.
Thanks, mate. Slight crosswind from the right, just make it a little bumpy in a minute, please.
Flying over different terrains and different winds, and in this case it was quite a strong crosswind, can make the flight quite turbulent.
And you are good left.
This, you know, can cause motion sickness, you know, which can make the patients quite nauseated and can cause them to vomit.
Anthony,
yeah.
You okay? Take some deep breaths. You gonna be sick? Spit it out. Get the fresh air, and that's going to be good.
Not what Anthony needed after an already difficult day. But at least now he's in the hands of the trauma team, who can hopefully mend his fracture. As Jeremy and Paul suspected, Anthony had broken his femur. He was in hospital for nearly 2 weeks and on crutches for another six. He's decided not to climb any more ladders and used a scaffolding tower to finish the job on his roof.